In the central district of Bhumtang, like every evening at 8:30 p.m., Sangay says goodnight to her husband. Tonight, she is not going to sleep in her bed. 6 months a year, she has to head to the field to guard potato crops from attacks of wild pigs.
So give in that.
Give in that.
Sangay, who is well into her 60s, explains to us that night guarding is a harsh task. At 5 in the morning, Sangay can go back to her home. Human-wildlife conflict is a widespread problem in rural Bhutan. Leopards, elephants, tigers, wild pigs, black bears, porcupines, and deers are among the animals that cause the most trouble to rural communities. Since ancient times, people have been trying to protect their crops by night guarding, constructing fences with stones, or using barbed wire and alarm fencing.
In the south, we have the elephant and the pig problem. In the central, we have mostly with the pig, wild pig, and also the bear problem, black bear. And we have also problem with the tigers in some of the cases, like in the past in the central region of Antongsa, there were man and tiger conflict issues. So man was been killed by tiger.
Loss of crops and livestock can represent unbearable losses to rural populations. As a result, retaliatory killings of wildlife are the easy way out. In 2011, the Poverty Environment Initiative, together with the Representation Office of Denmark and the Gross National Happiness Commission, supported the Royal Society for Protection of Nature to devise a community-led insurance scheme to support farmers that had suffered crop and livestock losses. The scheme started with 200,000 Bhutanese guildrum, around $3,300, and was maintained with membership fees paid by farmers. Households set up a committee and worked out a basic formula to calculate compensations for livestock and crop losses. The scheme ran through 2012 into 2013, and within the first 6 months, 20 compensation claims had been received and attended to. This community-led compensation scheme adds up to a number of other initiatives and programs launched to counter problems caused by human-wildlife conflicts. It is an excellent example on how community-led action can preserve Bhutan's rich biodiversity and meet the needs of farmers like Sangay, who make up around 69% of the country's population.